Growing up, some of my earliest memories as a child are waking up on Saturday mornings, right when the sun begins peeking from the tree line. My dad and I, we'd get up and we'd go to the flea market, and it was the highlight of my week, and honestly, I don't remember a time where it wasn't one of my favorite places on earth. My mom hates the flea market. She said one time that it feels old, and that it's as dark as a dungeon. The reason why she hates it are some of the reasons why it holds so much value to me. It is entirely a realm of its own. The following documentary is a collection of interviews, conversations, and encounters from a single day at the flea market.
Just to explain who you are and what you do here.
I'm Robert. I work at this booth for my sisters and our boyfriend. She lets me use this booth to set my stuff, mostly my stuff, some of it provides the time. My sister and her boyfriend have been here longer than me. I've been taking over because she's been ill, so probably about 10-something years. I used to be a big reader back in when I back in high school after I lost my hearing. That'd be keep me up. It was a good hobby. Collecting comic books and everything, and shoot the breeze with other people that collect his stuff.
Your favorite superhero is obviously Superman.
Yeah, Superman, but I'm leaning more to Marvel now because I really do like the movies.
The new one's coming out soon, Avengers Endgame. Did you see the trailer for that? That looks really good. It's going to be 3 hours long.
Yeah, that's going to be a problem for me because I find out that special device they use for cook capture.
Yeah.
It only good for about 2 or something hours, and that battery.
Yeah.
So I'm not sure how I'm going to be able to watch the whole thing.
Because
it's going 3.5 hours, actually. With the credits and the teasers.
Yeah.
So.
For the Captain Marvel movie, the new one that just
Which
came
one?
Out.
DC or Marvel?
It's for Marvel. Yeah, isn't that weird? For the new...
I just saw it yesterday.
Did you? I haven't even seen it yet.
Yeah, I like it.
Do you like the opening when it was all a memorial to Stan Lee?
Stan Lee, yeah. The credits, yeah. That was pretty cool. I met him once years ago. He was really nice guy.
You met Stan Lee?
Way back, he was at a comic convention in Columbus, Ohio. Wow. He was really nice guy. I remember... A kid came with a Batman comic book and asked him to sign it. Stan Lee didn't blink, he just signed and said, "Have a good day." That was funny.
How long have you been into comic books?
Back when I was in high school, for years, I used to collect so many comic books. I was running out of space and I just had to start selling some of it because I just, the comic books, bag them, board them, put them in those boxes. It would take a lot of time and spaces.
Do you find that it would make you more money to kind of switch over to like eBay or something like that?
Oh, I used to do that, but I ran into a few problems. One thing is statues. They're really hard to ship because, you know, if they get broken or something, some of these statues are one of a kind and... I hate the ship and especially something like that. That thing's heavy and huge. People like to know what's going on. They find out what's going on here, who's selling what, this and that. And they have to talk about the great find they find, you know, something they find that they outside or whatever, and they made a good deal, they've been looking for it. I've seen some people find something here that they've been looking for years and they finally find it.
Alright. I think I'm all out of questions for you.
Here, I'll set the camera down real quick.
Hey man, thank you for your time.
Yeah, thank you.
Oh.
Yeah, thank you.
Thanks for your time.
Okay.
Give you a good deal on that cat version.
No.
Okay, I got one for $75 right now.
Yeah,
we're looking around. It won't fit in the car.
I'll make it fit, Garfield. That door or that trunk, I'll make it fit.
Yeah, no focus.
You want to see what I brought it in? Here?
Yeah.
That orange car right there, I brought it in. I bring all my furniture in. I squeeze it in, and sometimes my wife can't believe that I could get. I used to have a Town and Country, but now I have a HHR Chevy.
That's so funny to me.
It's small. It's tiny. Yeah. It's really small.
You were fitting that big furniture into that.
In that, yeah.
That's great.
He's watching us, so that's why I'm going like that. He's a miserable old bastard. I'm miserable, but I'm not a bastard. But see, I get away from that mercy. I just go home and have myself a nice big Crown Royal on the rocks. Drink that all down, put some tunes on, and dance, baby.
My name is Wade Adams. We're at Jamie's Flea Market here. And place is open on Wednesday and Saturday from 8 in the morning till 4. We buy and sell original, a lot of really nice, unique stuff, like this boat here. A prisoner Bill that, you know, he was in from like 2 to 5 years, I guess. And that's how they spend a lot of their time, making jewelry boxes and making boats and making all kinds of things that they sell for cigarettes and money so they can buy stuff at their store. And the whole thing is made out of matchsticks, thousands of matchsticks. Younger people don't collect anything anymore like the older people. To the younger people, this is like a museum. They come through just to see what was around 20, 30, 40 years ago. But they don't really buy or collect. It's mostly the older people, and the older people are dying off. So now you have less and less people. Another place just like this closed down because not that many people were coming and buying, because you have to pay rent. So you have to look for stuff, buy it, sell it, pay your rent, and hope you make a little money extra. Yeah. It's not a place where you're going to get rich. You know, but I'm retired, my wife's retired, so it gives me something to do. This table over here I made because I used to make all the stuff for NASA space shuttle, and so I like to keep busy with my hands and my mind. I'm 72 years old, and it keeps me busy. You know, you can make a TV show just on the drama that goes on in flea markets, because everybody being different, everybody has a different theory, or they all collect different things and think that their stuff is really good. To some people you go, well, that's junk, mine's better. Or you would have, say, a lady meet a guy in here, and they're married, and next thing you know, it's going around, oh, they're hanging out together, you know. So it's kind of like a little Peyton place, but it's good because a lot of the people in here are older, and they have nothing else in their life. So they come here to talk to people and be with other people just for something to do, you know, with their life, you know. We had 3 people come in and try to steal a bunch of stuff in the back.
Cool.
And everybody converged, you know what I mean? And they wound up throwing the stuff down and running out, and, you know, the police came and they caught one in the woods, and they caught another one by his car. You know, he had taken off, but again, because of the digital, they took a picture of him, you know, yeah. So they knew the car, the license plate number, and they caught him down the street. And the woman and the guy, the guy they caught, I seen in the woods. I don't know if they ever got the woman or not, you know. But yeah, that's why I say there's all kinds of, you don't know who's who in the zoo, you know.
Yeah.
So you've been practicing since I last seen you?
Yes.
Okay, well, I know
that four
when you skip lessons, you know, you miss lessons, sometimes you get a little rusty and you forget what's going on. And
my name is Thomas Sebastian, and I am a professional stage illusionist, magician, and mentalist. And I started doing magic when I was 6 years old. And through the years, I've been very fortunate. I've gotten a chance to work with and perform on stage with some of the better, more known magicians. I worked with Doug Henning, Blackstone Jr. Never worked with him, but I have met and know David Copperfield. About 2 years ago, I worked with Fielding West out of Vegas, who used to open for the Rat Pack, you know, Frank Sinatra and Dean Martin and them, and Jay Berry. So over the years, I've gotten a chance to work with a lot of big famous magicians as well. Here, we've been here now going on 4 years. Back in this section, we've been here about 2 years back here. Since we've been here, there's been very little changes, but from what I understand, there's been big changes because people who have been here for about 24 years or even 14 years have said it has changed, because we used to get a lot of vendors and a lot of dealers from other places, people out of state. Now we seem to get mostly local people, and they seem to be the same people over and over and over, which is a shame, because there's a lot that Jamie's has to offer if people would just come out and give it a chance. Magic that makes me happy, almost any magic makes me happy, just performing makes me happy. I'm the happiest when I'm on stage performing, and it doesn't really matter what kind of magic, although I love cards because I started out as a card magician, so I'd say probably doing cards is probably one of my favorites.
How long have you been into magic?
Since I was 6 years old. I'm now 59. So I've been doing it, you know, a long time, 53 years. I've been doing magic. And I've been teaching for probably half that amount. This, by the way, is my student, one of my students. His name is Quentin. He's a fine magician in his own right. And so also, to answer your previous question, I would say also teaching also makes me happy as well. Most younger people today are so much into the technology. They're on the internet, and everybody wants to go to the internet and purchase their magic, or they want to go on the internet and learn all the secrets. I myself am pretty much against a lot of what's on the internet where magic is concerned, because they reveal too many secrets. The flea market and our magic shop, and we're kind of like a circus, we're a dying breed, but our magic shop is the only place that you can come and you can actually get trained by a magician and have hands-on. You buy something from the internet, even if you're watching on the internet, you don't have a magician, a professional magician, to train you. We're here at the flea market, here in our magic shop. Anything that you want to learn, we can teach you, and we teach you ourselves. So younger people, the best way of learning thing is to find a mentor, a teacher, just like Quentin has. We joke every now and then that sometimes the flea market is kind of like one of the biggest social clubs there is, because not only are we selling and buying here, but we're also getting together, we're socializing, we're talking, and we're doing the kind of communication that man was meant to do, and that's face-to-face, one-to-one. The internet is so impersonal. Now, there are places on the internet for magic, there are things for magic that we can use it for, but I think it's impersonal. Everybody is, you know, tied into that texting. Real communication is where you talk to each other face to face, and the flea market definitely promotes that. So it promotes a lot of different things, social behavior and talking and communicating together, and that's what we're here for. How you guys doing? Thomas Sebastian here. We're gonna show you a little magic, and in fact, we're gonna show you probably one of the oldest illusions that's ever performed. It's called the cups and balls, and it goes back to Egypt, 4,000 years ago. Now, in those days, they used to use their cups from the temple, and they'd use one, two, and three cups. They would use little stones or pebbles. I'm gonna use little soft balls, three balls. Now, the cups are solid, but if you watch very carefully, they also appear like they go through one another. If I take a little ball and put it on top of the cup, snap the finger, the ball goes all the way through the cup. Isn't that cool? Covered the first one, put the second one up there, and look. Now we got two of them that pass through. We'll cover those two. And this time we're going to try to go through three cups all together. One, two, three. And the third ball drops down. Now that's pretty cool. But you know, a lot of times in the old days, about 4,000 years ago, they thought the cups had magical powers. I actually believe it's the balls that have the powers, because if I take the little ball over here, you know it's in this hand. But again, if you watch it very carefully and I throw it towards the cup, it goes back underneath the cup just like that. We could do that again.
people disappearing. We have people appearing and disappearing around here all the time. So if I raise this up here like that, you see it's gone back, just like that. So if I take this ball, put that back in my pocket over here. Now, of course, we got over here. That's my lunch, by the way. So we'll take that and put that over here. Now, of course, we still have this one here, okay? So there we go. We take that one, we put that there. Come over here. Now we got this one over here. So we could do this all day. Put this one in my pocket, and of course, now we have a big ball over here. We'll take that one over there. If I go like this, we still have those two as well. And that's the cups and balls. You can do all sorts of things with these things. Absolutely fantastic.
My name is Jamie. This is my store here at Jamie's Flea Market. Name of my business is Fat Daddy's. Fat Daddy's Comics. I have two stores here at Jamie's Flea Market as well as the Medina Antique Mall. I've been here for about a year and a half with my partner Carl, who sells sports cards and nostalgia, and been a cool ride so far. I've been here shopping here since the late 1990s, and so I have many nostalgic memories of that era. I would say that as the economy goes, so goes the flea market. A lot of times as the economy is tough, sometimes you will see people who are desperate for money, who many times will bring out treasures that otherwise normally they wouldn't bring. But the flip side of that, when the economy is good, people are willing to invest in things that they may want but don't really need. So you kind of get the best of both worlds here at Jamie's. There are certainly regulars that are here with their flashlights first thing in the morning as soon as people start setting up. It's an eclectic group of people and pickers who, behind every picker, there's somebody, number one, who wants to make money, and number two, they want to save a piece of Americana of their own personal history, their own emotional attachments. And so these little clusters of people and collectors, they look out for each other here at Jamie's. And a lot of the vendors here at the flea market, this is their social life. They may not sell a thing, you know, in a given day, but they still enjoy the socialization with other vendors and customers. And so, thankfully, we have a little bit of both, a good relationship with other vendors as well as selling stuff. So, like I say, it's been a good business venture for both of us.
To me, anyway, flea markets are this last American vessel in a world gone digital, where people from all sorts of backgrounds come together twice a week to exchange in things from the past, where hellos and goodbyes are regular, where at any corner you can brush against something you've never seen before. I think in today's world, where we've never been so connected yet so distant from each other, that maybe, just maybe, we could learn a thing or two from a place like this. I know I have.
The rain never falls, the sun never shines, it's dark as a dungeon way down in the mine. Well, it's many a man that I've seen in my day. No laughing during the song, please. It's been recorded, I know, hell. Don't you know it's recorded? Like a pin with his dope and a drunkard with his wine, a man will have lust